spoken word artist, known for his unique blend of hip-hop and Arabic poetry. Fendem was recently named a Kennedy Center Citizen Artist Fellow, an Arab American Foundation 40 Under 40 Award recipient. Let's all welcome Omar Offendum to the stage.
Hey, thank you, thank you, thank you. Before I begin, can we have a round of applause for all of the organizers and all the vendors and all the volunteers making this beautiful event possible for us today? Want to keep that round of applause going for one person in particular, Muna Abdul Hamid, who was responsible for bringing not just me, but my dear friend Kareem here. Thank you so much for all your hard work and support of the Arab community in Atlanta. Now, for those who are not familiar with my work, I just want to say once again, I am a rapper and a poet. I have been charting this course for the last 20 years. I was named 40 under 40 when I was under 40. I'm no longer that. And I have the good fortune of being joined by Kareem Naji, who is going to be presenting his music to you later this afternoon. But I wanted to start it off with him, with a very special piece that we put together called Mother Earth. And on that note, I just wanted to make an acknowledgement. We are on indigenous land here, and it is important to remember that. Everywhere we go on Turtle Island, there was a story written long before we got here as immigrants. A story that also involved not just the displacement of the indigenous and the enslavement of Africans, and the building of an economy that we can all plug into here when we immigrate, but without understanding the foundation of it, it's very tricky to move forward in a time like this. And so it's important to remember the history in order to know where you're going. This one right here is called Mother Earth. And once again, Kareem Naji on the buzuk joining me. Is it a clock? Or is it a bomb? Is it a poem? Or is it a song? And I've been making music for over a decade, and yet they keep asking me if it's haram. Brother, go ask your mom or an imam. I'd rather the former, but that's just my preference. Or here's a suggestion. Pick up a Quran. It's for those who think. Reflecting upon this heavenly reference, we ponder and question his many a blessings from husbands and wives to nations and tribes. Striving to know one another's the lessons. Tolerance beckons at every petty divide. 'Tis better to settle with egos aside, for what hangs in the balance is more than our pride. It is lions and rhinos and tigers and eagles too feeble to hide. When solar flares can choke the air and roast the hairs of polar bears who've grown so rare, but floating over there, it's hopeless, no one cares. But don't despair. The coast is clear for those who know how to cope and share with open hearts, not evil eyes. For Mother Earth, she will survive. Yeah, she will survive. Listen, we live in love with hope and pride that Mother Earth, she will survive. We push and shove, poke and pride, but Mother Earth, she still survives. And even if mankind should die, Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth, she will survive. Oblivious to all the borders men of ignorance create. Fumbling over nation states that crumble when tectonic plates rumble. Warning signs to keep us humble as we boldly procreate. Segregate then subjugate her from the deserts to the jungles. Wow. Presidents and kings keep building statues of their arrogance. And religious zealots argue over arbitrary narratives, reducing God to a facade to make you think that the imperative is how you dress or where you pray or maybe what names you've inherited. Look. Such games are embarrassing, trivial to truth seekers who've been living their lives convivial, searching deep within for proof. Our teachers keep us in the loop, a generational gravitational orbit towards our precious youth, forever true, forever true. Prophetic reapers of the seeds we've sown, our health is our wealth. poetic martyrs preach to each his own, as life's longing for itself is in the eyes of sons and daughters, grand and great. The hand of fate is not a poem read by a psychic or a psalm read by a saint. No, it is the labor and the action and the work of decent men. It is the seconds and the minutes and the hours people spend preparing for our next of kin, for mothers. This is second nature. It's the brothers who lose sight and start these wars that complicate the war. So I say it again, she will survive. We live in love with hope and pride that Mother Earth, she will survive. We push and shove, poke and pry, but Mother Earth, she still survives. And even if mankind should die, Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth. Live in love with hope and pride that Mother Earth, she will survive. Push and shove and poke and pry, but Mother Earth, she still survives. And even if mankind should die, Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth, she will survive. Our Mother Earth, she will survive. Say inshallah.